What's going on, guys? Fuller with Custom Offsets, Custom Offsets TV on YouTube. We got Dustin here. I'm wearing a cowboy hat because I put it on as a joke, but now I've completely ruined my hair, so it's just gotta stay. So now we're gonna have like, you know, a couple two tree videos with cowboy hat on. Another episode of This or That, so we're gonna jump in. Keaton's gonna ask the questions. Before we do that, you have less than a week left, I'm pretty sure. This goes up on a Wednesday, to pick up this hoodie, which gets you automatically entered to win free wheels, free tires, free suspension. We got black label lighting, offset scraps to do the build if you wanna come up to Wisconsin. It's gonna be a good time.
King of Hammers or SEMA?
I've never been to either.
Oh man, this, I don't know how you're gonna answer it.
I don't know if I can.
The internet. Well, I was just at King of the Hammers, which, you know, makes me want to choose King of the Hammers. It's a really good time. But SEMA's also a really good time. You know, I'm gonna go with King of the Hammers because for me, I'm not much of a. I don't like the city. I don't like being in Vegas, really. Sure. It's just not my style. Being out in the middle of the desert with all these awesome builds, that was sweet. Now, you're not gonna see any crazy show stuff. There was a couple trucks. But most of it, obviously, is like hardcore off-road guys. So that was pretty sweet. And it's just, I don't know, the desert is an awesome place.
I have never been to the desert. I've never been to King of Hammers. And I've never been to SEMA. So this is strictly an internet-based perception. But I really wanna go to SEMA. I think SEMA's super cool.
If you've never been to SEMA and you do get the chance to go, definitely go. I know we kind of like downplay it because we get to go every year.
Right.
And eventually it kind of tends to be, you see the same people with the same stuff, you know, but they updated it a little bit. But if you haven't ever been there, you really should go because it's just amazing the caliber of work you see. And there's just a ton of different stuff there. Because there's off-road stuff, there's on-road stuff, there's muscle car stuff, tuner stuff, lifted show truck stuff. There's something for everybody. And you can walk for an entire week and still not see the whole show.
Yeah, I heard it's huge.
Massive.
So, yeah, I'm going to SEMA.
2019 Rocky Ridge Nissan Titan XD or 2020 Chevy Silverado Black Widow?
Ooh.
I think Black Widow truck's fucked. Here's what we're looking at.
All right.
So Rocky Ridge is like an approved upfitter, very similar to like SCA, you know, and making the Black Widow trucks, like all that stuff is like, you go to your dealership and they will have on the lot this already lifted truck on 22s, you know, and 35 inch, you know, Nittos or Toyos or something like that. They're just certified upfitters for the dealers.
Okay.
I am picking neither because if I'm buying a brand new truck, or even if you find one used, you know, I want to build the truck for me. I don't want somebody else to build it, and especially considering they all have the same wheels, they all have the same grille, the same fender flares. Like, you can go spend, and they're not cheap, you can go spend 95 grand on a Black Widow if that's what you want to do.
Sure.
And then your neighbor is going to get one too.
Truck, right?
You know, I'd rather, just much rather, have my own thing.
Yeah, I guess I didn't know that was an option.
Which doesn't answer your question, but I'm sorry. I'm not picking either one of them.
If I had to pick one of the two, I would go with the Titan XD. Simply because I really like the fact that they paired, you know, they've got a Cummins stuffed in there, and it's kind of a neat looking truck, and it makes moderately decent power for what it is, so. Yeah, I'm going that way.
CO2 or Sean's Daily?
Ooh, we're getting all sorts of spicy with the local trucks today.
I actually just talked to somebody about this, and I said, I don't know who I was talking to. I hope it wasn't you. That, like, I think Sean's F250 is like an awesome
I think
daily
it was
driver.
Me.
Was it you?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Dang.
Because we had the same thoughts.
Yeah, it's just like, it's not overly tall. I like that it's power stroke.
Mm-hmm.
It's really wide, so like parking it can be an issue. But you know, if parking is your biggest problem, yeah, get over it.
Correct.
You park wherever you want and you just walk a little bit further.
Yep.
I like the whiteout. Obviously, both trucks are kind of that whiteout theme. But then he's got that custom color bronze, or like, it's almost like a root beer color. That's what I call it on the wheels. I love the way that looks. It's a bit too much white in some spots. I think I would at least put the Ford logos in black or something.
Sure.
So you get some sort of contrast there. But it's a great truck.
Yeah.
I enjoy driving it, and I'm not really allowed to drive it other than in the parking lot.
I have never driven it, but to me, that is, and this, I'm pretty sure we had this conversation, that's like the perfect daily.
Mm-hmm.
So you could still put turnover ball in that thing and slide it under a gooseneck and haul anything you want to. You can hook a bumper pull trailer to it and tow something down the road. You know, you can take it pretty much anywhere you want to take it, be that on or off the pavement, and not have a lot of issues.
Hypothetically speaking, if I was to have a truck like that, I would definitely keep the full emission system, because that is what the EPA wants.
Absolutely.
So I would never, you know, do anything to remove it.
No.
For more power,
never.
And better economy and towing reasons.
No.
Mm-mm. Yeah.
Mm-mm. Right.
Delete it.
Gone.
Big lift, small truck, or small lift, big truck?
I don't know.
The cowboy hat.
Is it the cowboy hat, or is it that it's Valentine's Day right now, and for some reason you and Emily have switched places and now neither of you can make decisions?
Oh, wow. Damn, I hope she watches this. I don't know. I think I would rather have a full-size truck with a smaller lift kit, I guess, than to have a tiny truck with a really big lift kit, because I feel like proportionally they just look like they're going to tip over. I've said it before, so I'm just going to go with that. And we just talked about how the F-250, it's leveled and it's got 14 lines and it looks great.
Yeah, I agree. And the other thing is, inevitably, if you have a big, like a massively lifted Tacoma, you're inevitably gonna send it over, you know, some questionable terrain.
I would, yes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So, you know, for that reason, I would be a little bit worried. You know, you might break something, roll it over, whatever. So yeah, I'm gonna go full-size truck with a leveling kit.
Slam Nissan Titan or lifted Honda Civic?
Slam a Titan all day long.
Yeah. No, I have seen a Slam Nissan Titan. I don't know if Keaton's gonna be able to find any video footage. This is how it always goes. But I've seen photos, and they don't look half bad.
Yeah, they look pretty cool.
You know, it's different.
Mm-hmm.
Honda Civic front wheel drive. Even if you lift it.
Yeah.
And what kind of Civic? Are we talking EK hatch? Are we talking 9
to 10? Could you imagine? Could you imagine an EK hatch on a lift kit with like 40s?
I'm just picturing the guys that take like the truck chassis, like they'll take like a K5 Blazer chassis or something like that, and it's on 40s. They just pop the body off and then they're like.
Drop like
Civic.
A VW bug or something
Civic.
On top. Ugh, gross. Mm-mm. Nope. Mm-hmm.
Pass.
Nope. Not for me.
Bonus question. Would you rather be bald but grow an amazing beard, or have amazing hair but be baby-faced?
Well, partner, I'd rather be bald with an amazing beard because I can wear this hat. I had to.
Damn, okay. Can I, if you could do neither, can I have both? I don't know. I have a great head of hair and an okay beard, so I'm very blessed that way. But I guess if I had to pick one, I would go bald with a beard, because you can always put a ball cap on. But beards are pretty cool. Other than when you're trying to record and they hit the mic.
Yep, other than that. But, you know, either way, really, I actually don't think I would be too upset either way. You're bald, you can throw a hat on. If you can't grow a beard, you can't grow a beard. Like,
that's
you
true.
you just work without it. You didn't have one for the first 20 years of your life.
And I looked like trash.
Well. Yeah, arguably correct.
Okay, all right.
We're getting too hostile here. That's another episode of This or That. If you guys want to ask us any more questions, you can drop them down in the comments below. Otherwise, I think that's it. Keaton wants me to do the finger gun thing and go, we're out of here.
Then you have to blow.
Oh.
Yeah!